Good morning. This is my tutorial, Kate Tutorials. I am Karthik Ravindra Kate. Today I am going to discuss about molecular weight of macromolecules. That is how to determine molecular weight of polymers or the macromolecules. If you are not the member of this channel, be the member by subscribing to this Kate Tutorials. See, to determine molecular weight, let us know few basic terminologies involved in this polymers. See, first one is degree of polymerization. The degree of polymerization is denoted by capital P. Degree of polymerization is defined as the number of monomeric units in a big molecule of polymer. That is, take the example of ethylene. Ethylene, the formula is CH2, double bond CH2. This is ethylene. This is monomer. The number of monomeric unit combined together in presence of high pressure and some catalyst, they combine together to form a polymer. That is CH2. Single bond CH2, single bond CH2, single bond CH2, like that it will keep on going. That is nothing but polymers, and it is generally represented as CH2, single bond CH2, and this is written as N times. The number of monomeric units combined together to form polymer. That is nothing but polymerization. The number of polymeric unit to form this big gate molecule is nothing but degrees of polymerization, and it is denoted by capital P. The next one is molecular weight of macromolecules or the polymers. See, the molecular weight of single molecule will be equal to the molecular weight of repeated unit multiplied by degree of freedom. This is nothing but they are telling, if small m is the molecular weight of this monomeric unit and capital M is the molecular weight or molar mass of this polymer. This is molar mass of monomeric unit, that is CH2. This is monomer, and this capital M is the molecular mass of this polymer. And they are telling the molecular weight of single molecule, that is single molecule means small m, and multiplied with the degrees of freedom P. Degrees of freedom P is given by capital M divided by small m. That is nothing but degrees of freedom. It is the molecular mass of the polymer divided by molecular mass of the monomeric unit, and we are going to get capital M, which is the molecular mass of polymer. So here I discussed of the degrees of freedom, and also the expression for degree of freedom is capital M divided by small m, where capital M is the molecular mass of the macromolecule and small m is the molecular mass of the monomeric unit. So they told that we can determine the molecular weight of a polymer by multiplying degrees of freedom with the unit mass, that is molar mass of the monomeric unit. So we get the molecular weight of polymer. But the problem is, see, but a macromolecule substance may not contain the macromolecule of same size or same length. See, if this is the monomeric units and they are going to combine together to form a polymer like this, we don't know the size of this polymer, it may not be the same, or the length of the polymer, it may not be the same. So how can we determine the molecular mass of the substance? That is the problem. Hence macromolecule will have different molecular weights. So they have different molecular weights, so we can't determine by using this formula. So then how to determine the macromolecular weight of the polymers? So macromolecules therefore cannot be assigned definite molecular weights. They can't be assigned, cannot be assigned definite molecular weight. Hence we take average molecular weight for such macromolecule substances. Then what is average molecular weight? See, the average molecular weight can be divided into two types. One is number average molecular weight, and the other one is mass average molecular weight. The number average molecular weight is denoted by capital M and small n, number average molecular weight, and mass average molecular weight is denoted by small m with capital M, that is mass average molecular weight. Then what is number average molecular weight and mass average molecular weight? Let us discuss that. See, the number average molecular mass or molecular weight is denoted by M with small n, that is Mn. It is obtained by dividing the total mass of the dispersed medium by the total number of molecule present. That is nothing but they are telling that is it is the total mass of the dispersed medium, that is Mn, is given by M1 plus into N1 plus M2 to N2 plus dash 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 divided by total mass of the dispersed medium. This is the total mass M1 N1. The number 1 is having molar mass of M1 and the second molecule is having molar mass of M2, and this is the sum, that is total mass divided by the total number of molecules, that is N1 plus N2 plus N3. And this can also be shown as summation of Mi Ni divided by summation of Ni. That is nothing but number average molar mass, where N1, N2, N3 are the number of molecules, number of molecules in that polymer, and M1, M2, M3, etc. are the mass of these molecules. That is nothing but the mass of these molecules. That is nothing but number average molar mass. Similarly, we have another mass average molar mass. The mass average molar mass is given by, see, the molar mass of each particle species is multiplied by the total mass of this species in the whole substance. These are added together for all the size particles and then divided by sum of masses of all individual size particles to give the mass average molar mass. This is nothing but mathematically it can be easily shown as M of M, because mass average is denoted by M of M. Mass average molar mass is nothing but that is M1 square N1 plus M2 square N2 plus dash 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 divided by mass M1 N1 plus M2 N2 plus dash dash dash. And it can be denoted by summation Mi square Ni divided by summation Mi Ni. This is about mass average molecular mass. In next class, we are going to discuss about how to determine molecular weight of macromolecules. There we have two methods. One is osmotic pressure method and other one is viscous method. By using these two methods, we can determine the molecular weight. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you feel like to share with your friends. Thank you.